double shot injection resin casting using different polyurethane resin durometers, kind of like how they make toothbrushes. And I'm going to use an undercut key lock to make a three-part silicone mold.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred backpack hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys, super versatile. So I'm packing up some here that were recently sold. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel.
This video is sponsored by PCBway. They're currently having a Christmas sale. Flex PCBs starting at $89. CNC machining starting at $24.89 from your 3D CAD. And HDI buried blind vias for your PCBs starting at $300. For your next project, check out PCBway. Here's our mold box and our sheet of glass that we're gonna cast everything on. The two pieces of aluminum are my master parts. They've been prepared, they're the right size. The one on the right is 1.1 and the one on the left is 2.3 millimeters. And these are gonna be our master parts that we're gonna cast the silicone around to make our molds with. This is my 3D printed keyway. You also note in the top corner here on the right hand side is a notch, and this allows the molds to go back together in the same orientation. With this undercut 3D keyway, it allows the two halves of the molds to lock together more securely. The undercut will make the two pieces grab together, and it will reduce the amount of flash and just hold everything together securely in the correct way. So this 3D printed key is really very, very important and integral to the whole mold making process. So to make the first half of the mold, we will glue down the key and the first part of the mold, being the thicker part. We'll glue that down with some PVA, let it dry. We'll mix up some silicone here. We'll put it into the vacuum tank and we will degas the silicone. This is important. You want to remove all the air bubbles or as much as you can so that there's no chance of any air bubbles in the silicone, so that you have a good mold and there's no imperfect surfaces. We spent a lot of time to set everything up and we want it to come out really good. Once the silicone has cured, then we'll take the mold box apart so that we can remove the glass and take that master part out. Here I am, I'm just prying the glass off of the mold. Use a scraper. The beautiful thing about the PVA is that the glue, the white glue, just comes off really nice and easy. We'll remove the key. I'm trying to keep the master part intact in here, but there's a little bit of flash that creeped underneath the part in between the glass and the part, and so I need to take it out. Ideally, you want to leave that in place, but that can often be difficult. And here I am just trimming off a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of flash from the silicone around the edges. And then I trim the backside of the mold here, and this is so that the mold will lay flat and not be bowed. Let's reassemble the original silicone mold and we'll apply two layers of release agent. This is made with petroleum jelly and naphtha. And we put the release agent everywhere where we're going to be pouring silicone that's not exposed. We put the master part back in the mold and we're going to close the mold box back up. We'll use some of these acrylic rods that I have sharpened in a pencil sharpener, one for the pour sprue and one for the vent sprue. We'll mix up some silicone, and this is what's going to go on top of the first part of the silicone mold that we made to make the second half. We'll degas that as well. Now we'll pour the silicone on top of the first mold half that has the release agent on it. Once that's cured, we'll disassemble that and we'll take it out, remove the vent and the pour sprue, and separate the two halves of the mold. We've made one complete mold so far, and we're going to glue the 1.3 millimeter thick piece of aluminum on top of the other master part. This is going to give us our additional thickness. We're going to come back in, add more release agent, and put in some more pour and vent sprues as well. And then that will allow us to make the second part of the mold when we inject the resin in there. You'll see how that works out. So let's mix up some silicone here. And then this is going to make the third part of the mold. Mix it up really good. I add a tiny bit of colorant just to make the color of the silicone a little bit different, to help me differentiate so I don't put the molds together incorrectly later on. I can tell actually which one is which, but it just helps. A little bit of color is a little extra. Pour that over just like we did before. Let it flow out from one spot. This helps eliminate air bubbles and gives you good coverage. Once the silicone has cured, we will take things out of the mold box again, remove the sprues, trim off the edges so that the mold can lay flat when we go to pour the final parts, and we'll take the silicone molds apart, and you can see the two aluminum pieces in there. And now we have the three parts. We got the part on the left to cast the first half. We'll remove that, and then we'll apply the second part of the mold that we did there for casting the second part of. Now, I ordered a whole bunch of urethane resin, different durometers from Rampf. They're little quartz sample sizes of the various durometers that I need for this project, and this is how they come. I'm just opening them all up, taking the tape off that they put on for shipping, and we'll start by casting the 55A shore durometer material that goes on the bottom with a thicker part of every one of these parts. We're going to make the thicker part first. This is a pretty thick urethane rubber. It takes a lot to degas it, and it's so thick that it won't just flow. I have to inject it into the mold. You'll see how the mold is tipped lower at the bottom in the corner where I inject there. And then here's where the resin comes out the vent on the other side. And you can see, under pressure even, how thick that material is. We put that into the pressure tank, and we're gonna cure that for a couple of hours at maybe about 110 degrees and 60-ish PSI of pressure. This will give us a really good, clean first base part of our two-part urethane cast. We'll remove the top of the mold. You can see the parts in there. I leave that in there. I'm going to trim off a little bit of the sprue and the vent. So we'll take this third part of the mold and we'll place that on top of the original cast part. We will mix up a different durometer of resin. Now, it's really important to get the best bond between the two different durometers of resin. You want to do the second pour or the second injection within a couple of hours, maybe 2-3 hours of the first one while it's almost still tacky. Again, this stuff is also pretty thick. We have to inject it in here at the low spot so that it will come out the other side. We'll remove the syringe, put in a little straw so that the resin can flow back out and normalize inside the mold. Again, under pressure, 60 PSI, about 110 degrees F. So not super hot. We'll remove the vent and the pour sprue. We'll take that apart. And now we have a double shot cast. I had a few failed parts, some with air bubbles. Those weren't really big, but my big takeaway from this was when I left the syringe plunger inside of the syringe in the mold and then put that into the pressure tank. When it cured under 60 PSI, it forced the resin back into the syringe and caused voids in the molds. And so you want to avoid that and take the syringe out. So for these sample parts for my client, I ended up making 5 different ones so that they could try them out in their product development and then choose which ones they like the best. And then I made more after that.
All right, these are the different durometers. They all have the same back side durometer of like a 55A. And then all the front sides are different. So starting with like a 70D, 85D, 60D or 100A, 95A, and an 85A. So super flexible on this one. And then this one, 70D is pretty rigid.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.